Hello and welcome. I've called the method shave of the object Heinz. Method shave was inherited from the sub-object head. Yeah? And I reduced the attribute facial hair to a minimum. Okay? Welcome to our next video about object orientation and programming. Last time we did a blink sketch, object oriented. Turned out that it was quite a source code afterwards. Yeah? However, we managed. Yeah? We said there is the pin. We said there is a derived class from the pin class is the digital output. And we introduced the methods set and reset. We ended up in quite a source code, pretty big, where everything is inside. There is inside the definitions, there is inside the logic, there is inside our main program. You know, now we try to get a little bit more order in this system somehow, that we're getting smaller portions we can deal with simply. So this is the program from last time. So this is the program from last time. I will save it now under new name. It's 44 blink 00 multiple. I call it multiple because I want to use multiple source files here. I want to divide all those stuff in multiple files. Save. How do I do this? I mean, how? Up here, the Arduino IDE, there is a little element, a little button. Press it, press new tab. And now we can enter a file name, a new file name, and I will call it pins.h. Why h? So-called header. Maybe if you remember, when we used libraries, we also used h files. Show the screen, this here, pins.h. Here I have this entered, okay? Okay, now I got this. YH, H is a so-called header file. When we used libraries, we wrote here include and the library name. And now I will include pins.h. And puck, I'm now including this file. Where is this file located? This file is located in the same directory. If I now say save as, and enter here to this, you see multiple. I have not saved it. Save, of course. Save. Now I should see it. Multiple. See, there's pins.h. It's in the same subdirectory like the project. What is a header file? A header file usually contains definitions. Okay, so I will copy in there my definitions. Copy the pin class definition, pins, and I will copy in the digital output class. It's in. Let's try to compile this, because now I've used the second file. Compile it. Seems to work. Yeah. Upload. Yeah. Still the same. Still working. Blinking. Everything's all right. So this worked, Now I've used it another file, but now I want to know it. Yeah? Is there a possibility that we also get rid of all those stuff, this programming? Huh? Well, we could try to copy this also. To copy this also to the H file. Let's try it. Compile. Working. Okay. Also working. Download. Verify. Working. Wonderful. Yeah. However, I do just shift now the problem from one file to the other file. Yeah. I want to divide the definition and the programming in two files. So I add another file. I again press the button above here. So press the button, new tab, and I call it pins.cpp, C++ source file. Okay. Here we have the C++ source file. Good. And I want to use this stuff here in the source file, the corresponding source file. Let's see if this is still working. No. Pinglass does not name a type. Why? Because these source files, they are generated one by one. And if it's generating, compiling pins.cpp, it doesn't know the ping class, of course. Yeah? So I have to use here hashtag include pins.h. Now verify. Still not working. Aha. Why is that? Because now it's compiling this file at first. Yeah. Tries to compile pins.h and now it tells me there is a lot of things telling me. But the first one, byte does not name a type. Byte does not name a type. Does the byte? The byte type is no longer known. Why is that? This is because some type definitions and so on are in the include file. Include Arduino.h. Arduino.h. There are things defined like, for instance, commands, Arduino commands like pin mode, like digital write, digital read, analog write. These are defined there that our stuff here, our program knows this. We have to include Arduino.h. But after now, this was not necessary, right? Yeah, this was because here in our Eno file, it is added automatically. However, it's now first compiling the CPP file. There it's not added. So I added here Arduino.h, see if this is now working. There it is. Already working. Now I know again the type byte. Okay, we have solved this. So we will also move now this whole stuff, this digital output thing, to the CPP, check it, verify, compiling, upload, and blinking, blinks. See, if I'm changing the timing, see if this is really the correct program, and upload once again. Yes, different pattern, wonderful, working, 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 working. Okay, now, what have we done? We divided this into several source files. So we have one source file for the program. This looks pretty. The overview is given now. Okay, there's digital output, class digital output. We call it LED and we use the LED set and reset here. This looks like we could read it very fast. Yeah? Then in pins.h, we're including here pins.h. In pins.h, we have the two class definitions, but only the definitions, pin class and digital output. Okay. Then in CPP, we do have the code for the classes. So we divided this into several files, and this gives much, much, much more overview. Okay. Now, let's say we are doing accidentally this a second time. We included a second time the pins.h. Now it does not really, now it looks really stupid, but if we have several source files, this might happen, because then this source file maybe include pins.h, and another source file also includes maybe pins.h. And then we have several object files somewhere. Yeah. And then when linking, I got several times the same class definition inside. Ooh, that's not too good. Yeah. If I try to compile this now, here we have it. Yeah. It says here, pin class. Yeah. Redefinition of class pin class. Redefinition. Yeah, I defined it a second time. Just because I added here this line. Yeah? And if this line is in another source file somewhere or another header file, yeah, because here I could also write include and then I include two header files and both include the same file. Ooh, then, yeah? How to overcome this? Because this will happen. I mean, this will happen. Here, so-called compiler directives are helping us. Okay? What is a compiler directive? We know one, define. Okay. We can define a compile time constant. And if it, I define now a compile time constant, I start with a line, just to have some prefix or something like this, and I will call it pins age. Okay. This defines now the constant pins age. It is empty, but it does not matter, it is defined. Okay. And there is a compiler directive if endef, if not defined. Yeah. And now pins age. Yeah. If not defined pins age, then define pins age and do this stuff. And I have to add also somewhere a endif. Yeah. So this if starts here for the compiler. No, it's not seed for the compiler. And this endif starts here. So everything between if not def and endif is only executed if this pins.h is not defined. So when we include it the first time, this pins.h is not defined, we will run it through, we will define it. Yeah? If we include it the second time, this pins.h is suddenly defined and we are not going to include it. Such if def, if endef and so on, this can be used to remove parts of the code even. Yeah? Remove or only compile codes if they are really necessary. In the end, yeah, this Arduino constant for the LED building, this is exactly also solved with such things. Yeah? Inside the Arduino H, the correct Arduino H for about board type, there is, depending on the board type, this has a different value simply, this LED built-in. Yeah? These are just such compiler things. Yeah? Now let's try if this is working before I... Papa! Even I use it here a second time, it is working now because I only use it once, real. Because I made this little trick here. Good, right? You should do this little trick, because you cannot guarantee. Here, it's a very small program, but if you have it distributed over several source files, it's getting difficult. Save. The spin CPP, this is also located in the same directory, and all INO files, all CPP files, all C files, they are compiled. One by one, the pins, in our case pins, so the CPP is compiled. This my name thing here, this long INO file is compiled. We have two object files, they are linked together with the linker, and then there is the result file in machine code, which will be downloaded to our Arduino. Okay. Exactly like we've learned it. And this H file, this header file, is used to define stuff. Great. So, we learned a lot of stuff. We learned how to define classes. We learned how to derive classes. We learned what is a default constructor, what is an overloaded constructor, and so on. And we learned how to spread those things on multiple files to get a little bit order in this chaos of definitions and programming lines. However, this is not perfect. Far from perfect. This is why next time we are going to learn a little bit more of inheriting. Especially this case with this default constructor. I mean, right now it's possible that we are producing a pin which has no number. This is not nice. Just because we want to inherit it. Let's see if this we can overcome. Or also the inheritation, it can be different. I'll show you next time, in next video. For this time, thank you very much for listening. Goodbye.